past performance may not be indicative of future results. Therefore, no current or prospective client should assume that the future performance of any specific investment, investment strategy, including the investments and or investment strategies recommended and or purchased by advisor or product made reference to directly or indirectly will be profitable. Different types of investment involve varying degrees of risk, and there can be no assurance that any specific investment will either be suitable or profitable for a client's investment portfolio. No client or prospective client should assume that any information presented serves as the receipt of or substitute for personalized investment advice from the advisor or any other investment professional.
The following program is pre-recorded. Listener calls are not being taken at this time. Thanks for listening to AM 1420, The Answer. Welcome to the Bullington Capital Report, hosted by Bill Bullington. For the next hour, you'll receive information on current market conditions and trends that could affect your financial future. If you have a question, you can participate in today's program by calling 216-901-0945. That's 216-901-0WHK. You can also reach Bill by going to his website, bullingtoncapital.com. And now, here's Bill Bullington.
Well, welcome back. Sure has been an interesting year. Unbelievable. A lot of people not real happy, I understand. And you just have to understand that the stock market's going to fluctuate a lot. Anybody that's ever listened to this show since I started back in 1996, where my first official pick was Qualcomm, by the way, and it sucked at nothing for 2 years. It went sideways in a 40% trading range. And I'll let you go back and look up what it did after that. But anyway, nobody knew who it was then. And today it's so funny because they knew it for a little while, mainly just because it had gone up so much. And then they did a spinoff that went up a lot. And, you know, they're the reason that you have a cell phone that they call a smartphone. The brains behind that is the chip that Qualcomm makes and the software that they own the patents to. And so anyway, that was interesting. It was fun. And there's always an element of luck involved. I don't care what you're doing. You know, Qualcomm could have been surpassed by another chip company. If Intel had known or if AMD had known how big that market was going to be at some point in time, they had enough in resources just to put those guys out of business. So you just never know. There's always a fairly large element of luck involved. And that's why as you get older, you really don't want to be loading up on individual stocks. It's okay to invest in them. I would never put more than, probably 5% of my total assets into an individual stock if I were past the age of 65. If I have more than 5% of my money in an individual stock and I am past the age of 65, I would look to diversify that. But that's me. That's me with 32 years of experience and a lot of it school of hard knocks. So I always said, I started saying this about 10 years into my career. Experience is the best teacher, especially when it's somebody else's. If you can learn from someone else's experience, you're actually fairly unique. Most people can't. But those that can save themselves a lot of anguish. And so I try to share a lot of this stuff that I've learned over the years on this program. And I really appreciate all the people that I talk to that say, hey, I try to catch your program every time I can. Very nice. Thank you. I appreciate that immensely. And I'll try to keep doing a good job. And if you have questions that you would like to see answered on this program, you can always go to my website at bullingtoncapital.com and you can request or have a question. Send me a question. I can't tell you how many people go there. They find the information request page and then they forget to write in the question where it says question in the box. So I have no idea what they're actually looking for. But you can do that, bullingtoncapital.com. I'd be glad to try to answer questions the best of my ability. And we're going to be talking today a little bit about the same things we talk about almost every week here. We're looking at the economy. Most people think that the economy is a leading indicator for the stock market, and that's not correct. The stock market is a leading indicator for the stock market, actually for the economy. The Fed looks at stock prices because they know there are people who manage an awful lot of money, who have contacts with people, or they, like BlackRock, sits on the boards of an awful lot of companies that they invest in. Now, they're a mutual fund manager, or actually mostly exchange-traded funds. It's another type of a fund. They're a fund manager, and they're sitting on the boards of these big companies, and they're influencing those companies' decisions. So they have the ability to respond and move to the things that they have access to that the rest of us won't have access to. They're not allowed to front run. That's a whole other argument. But they do have informed decisions. And so when they're putting money into the markets, you can kind of see where they're going just based on the speed of the fund, how fast it's going up or down. Now, they are also subject to the whims of individual investors who take their money in and out of stock markets all the time. And you should probably try to not do that. That's not a good idea, is to try to guess. If you've got some sort of methodology, let's say it's based on relative strength, that's basically a form of price movement measurement. That's okay. But you better define that really well. The number one problem I've seen for the past 32 years, and it hasn't gone away. I thought 32 years, I started doing this show in 1996, so not quite 32 years. But I thought for sure everybody was going to figure this out and I would be unemployed by this time in my career. That's what I thought. Everybody's going to get this. It's not that hard. They'll understand and they won't need financial advisors in the future. And you know what? I'm still waiting for that day. But I get it. You know, it's like, it's not intellect. There are tons. You don't have to have above average intelligence to be a good investor, but you do have to have above average knowledge so that you feel comfortable when the market's dropping. Because if you're not comfortable when the market's dropping and you're panicking and selling your stocks when they're down instead of when they're up, that's a problem. That's probably one of the biggest problems. It is the biggest problem. It's not probably, it's the biggest problem that investors have. It's a lack of confidence that they lose at some point in time, and then they go to cash, and then they lock in losses, and then they miss out on a lot of gains. And it's hard. And if it were easy, I wouldn't be here. Wouldn't have a job. So the bottom line is you need a strategy. And the strategy doesn't even have to be that good. I've seen some really crappy strategies actually do very well if you give it enough time, or just strategies I thought were crappy. Turns out they're pretty good. I'm talking about some value-oriented strategies. I'll get into that a little bit later on today's show. There's a bunch of different strategies that you can use. There are funds out there that are doing it. And how do you identify them? We'll talk about that in the second segment of today's show. And we're also going to talk about fixed indexed annuities. Annuities are becoming a really big deal. They're playing a bigger role now than they've ever played. Why? Because the fastest growing segment of the population is 60 and over. Every day, 10,000 people are turning 60. Think about that for a second. I hope that the young people are having lots of kids. We need somebody because everybody's going to be on Social Security. There will be nobody there to support them. Yeah. And by the way, don't worry about that. The Social Security is fine. It's in extremely good shape. And when they first started Social Security back in the 30s, yeah, you had to be 65 to start collecting, which doesn't seem bad. You know, today 65 seems pretty good. But back in those days, the average life expectancy was 65. So they really didn't think they were going to have to be paying that much. And they figured that if you lived to that ripe old age, you were definitely going to need help. And incidentally, I don't know if this is true or not, but I had read somewhere that the average life expectancy in China is only 60. That's a little nuts because their birth rate is negative in that country. That means their population's getting old fast. And not sure what that means for, you know, their competitive position around the world, but, you know, we'll see. Definitely we'll see. One of the other things I wanted to kind of point out, I'm here looking at key economic indicators. I'm looking at the U.S. unemployment rate, 3.6%. 3.6. You know, when I was studying economics in college some 30 years ago, we were looking at an unemployment rate that was around 10% or so, which was considered pretty high. But they thought that a 5 to 6% unemployment rate was not attainable for any long period of time. Think about that. This current unemployment rate is 3.6%, and it's been below 5% for about a decade. And they were teaching not that long ago, at least I don't feel like it's that long ago, that that was unsustainable. You could never do that. Wasn't possible. Okay. Now, granted, they've also changed how they calculate the unemployment rate, which helps it look a lot lower than it was, but, you know, it's pretty interesting. I'm looking at the U.S. 10-year government bond interest rate, 3.13%. By the way, the shorter-term bonds are paying almost as much as that is. That's a big deal. If you're looking for stability in your portfolios, the rates are coming up a little bit there. So you can get, if you're getting shorter-term treasuries, 2.5%, no sweat. That's pretty good. You earn interest every day that you hold those, by the way. There's no commission to buy or sell it. The prices do fluctuate, but not a lot. You know, if you're buying a 1 or 2 or 3 year treasury, the price may fluctuate maybe in the basis points. That's 0.01%. But you're also collecting interest for every day that you hold it. There's no commission to buy or sell it. So if your account's big enough or if it's offered through your broker dealer, that's a good thing to look at right now. If not, if you just want to stick with funds, then yeah, you want to make sure the thing you want to look up with that is the average duration. Duration's a measure of how the portfolio moves relative to moves in interest rates. If interest rates go up and it goes down a lot, say like the TLT, that's a long-term treasury bond fund, that goes down a lot when interest rates go up. Well, that would have a duration of, say, like 20 years. It'll act like a 20-year bond will act. And it doesn't tell you how much it's going to go up or down. It just says the higher the number of years, the more fluctuation you're going to get. So anyway, that's the 3-cent version. If you look that up, they use a lot of 4- and 5-syllable words to describe what they're doing. I really don't like that. I'd rather stick with the average maturity, and I kind of know approximately how much the principal is going to fluctuate on a 30-year bond, just having looked at the charts for so many years. You know, you get a 1% increase in long-term interest rates, and you probably see 10 to 15% decline in a 30-year bond's price. Okay, it may make it up right away. You can't know that, but you can know that there's a really good chance that if interest rates go up by 1% and you're holding on to 30-year treasury bonds, there's a really good chance that bond's going to be down 10 or 12%. And that's a given. Now, having said that, let me give you an example. 2022, TLT, that's a treasury bond fund, 20-year plus treasury bond fund. Its price was 152. Okay, it's down 118. It's down to 118 right now. It's down 20%. You know what's really funny? Anybody that has a degree in finance or works for a bank or maybe the Fed, because the Fed's got an office here in Cleveland, they're listening to me and they're going, oh my gosh, this guy, he's going over a lot of stuff. Well, yeah, we'll come back to that as soon as we come back from these commercial messages. You're listening to Bill Bullington right here on 1420. Stay tuned.
Those who are hurt. Now that I've got your attention, let me tell you all about us. Whoa, tough crowd. Anybody out there? Hello? Anyone?
Fighting to be heard in today's competitive digital world?
It's time for Salem Surround. Let us handle everything and get your message seen and heard.
Let's turn up the volume on your business with Salem Surround.
Visit SurroundCleveland.com today. That's SurroundCleveland.com.
Always Right Radio with Bob Frantz.
Here's what the overwhelming majority of American people believe we must do. We need to ban assault weapons and high-capacity magazines.
You're a liar. In addition to bleeding stupid, you're a liar. The Second Amendment says that a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free people and of a free country, the rights to bear arms shall not be infringed.
Weekdays at 9 a.m. on The Answer.
And Odyssey.
From an idea that started in 1967, Our Lady of the Wayside has grown to serve almost 900 children and adults with developmental disabilities throughout Northeast Ohio. It's an operation that is still growing thanks to tremendous support and generous donations like the Wayside's car donation program. You can donate your ride to the Wayside for a great tax write-off by calling 1-800-368-6262. The Wayside is also looking for people to join their team. They hire for attitude and train for skills. Visit thewayside.org to apply today.
Do you ever find yourself saying, I need a vacation? Vacation Fixation can help. At Vacation Fixation, we specialize in all-inclusive trips and cruises to Mexico, the Caribbean, and Disney vacations. Why choose us? Our clients book through Vacation Fixation because they are frustrated with online trip brokers and timeshare scams. Whether it's a weekend getaway, a family trip, spring break, or honeymoon, Vacation Fixation will personalize a trip just for you. Want to know the hottest destinations in Cancun, Punta Cana, Jamaica, or Puerto Vallarta? Interested in room upgrades, beach reviews, or details about resort restaurants? How about finding a trip with a direct flight? At Vacation Fixation, we take all of your specific travel requests and shop our suppliers to find the best deal. What's the cost? Our suppliers pay us so you don't have to. Call 330-573-8147 for more details. Or you can visit our website at vacationfixation.com or check out the deal of the day on Facebook, Vacation Fixation.
Is it finally time to update your bathroom? Bath Planet, a division of Joyce Factory Direct, specializes in replacing and converting old showers and tubs into new, beautiful bathrooms in as little as one day. We have transformed thousands of bathrooms just like yours into a spa-like oasis that has homeowners excited to use their new bathtub or shower. Right now, all bath installations are 50% off. So call to schedule a free consultation with on-the-spot pricing. 440-243-5700 or visit JoyceFactoryDirect.com.
If you've just tuned in, this is Bill Bullington. I'm here every Saturday morning from 11 to noon. I am the CEO of Bullington Capital. There's only three of us there, by the way, so it's not a huge thing. We manage money for about 200 households, and we use huge custodians. Fidelity's a big one. Axos is another one, and there's a third firm that just got bought out by Goldman Sachs. So technically we're with Goldman Sachs there. And interesting. But if you'd like to, if you hear something you'd like more information on, just feel free to go to my website at Bullington Capital and inquire, or you can call 330-664-0700. That's 330-664-0700. And I will be giving that number out a couple more times before the end of the show. You know, we'd started talking about economics, and I'm telling you, man, what I see, the problem with the economy is not that the banks are going bad or loans are going bad, at least not yet anyway. That's a cyclical thing, and it tends to speed up and then slow down from time to time. But right now, the biggest problem with the economy is the supply. It's not demand. Demand is there. When you have lower demand because people are out of work, they're losing their jobs, the economy's hit the skids, the banks are losing money, those are big ones. Those are really big ones. Those are like the 50% kind, the kind that you saw from March of 2000 to March of 2003. That was mostly an overvaluation of the stock market. But the and then you go from 2007 through 2009, you know, the S&P peaked out in November of 2007. But what most people didn't realize that small, mid-cap, and international emerging markets were crashing that whole year. And the Standard & Poor's, the S&P 500, didn't start to drop until November of that year. And then it continued to drop through March of 2009. And at the end, it was down 50%. So if your luck was really, really bad, and you invested near the peak of the market in the year 2000, in 2009, you'd be down 50% if you never took out a dime. Think about that. You'd be down 50% if you never took out a dime. 10 years later, that's called, the risk for that is called sequence of returns risk. Because if you look at the long-term returns, despite the fact that you get those big drops like that, the long-term returns are somewhere around 9% or so, depending on which period you're going to look at. But you can have a 10-year period with negative returns. You need to understand that. When you're looking at an illustration or you're reading an article, nobody that I know of talks about that. I've never seen that mentioned outside of magazines for hedge fund managers or institutional investors. And I know why they don't want to talk about it, because they're afraid they'll scare everybody out of the stock market. Well, you know what? You don't think they're going to find out anyway? I mean, if they're invested in that, you don't think they're going to see those big declines like that? Yes, they will. You will. I will. And you know what? It's not a lot. You shouldn't be afraid of it. It's just the nature of the beast. If you don't have the ability to ride out a 50% decline, just don't put 100% of your money in stocks. It is that simple. If you can't stand to see it cut in half, don't put all your money in stocks. And by the way, by putting about half your money in something safe, okay, that gives you money that when you do see those big declines, you can actually add to it while everybody else is running, screaming, and scared. And when it recovers and then goes back, you'll be way ahead of the game. Now, that is a lot easier to say than it is to do, I promise you. It takes a lot of guts to be buying stocks when they're dropping. But, you know, I forget what the old saying is, chance favors the bold. Okay. And you don't have to be all that bold. You can have, right now, I don't think there's a need for people to be much more than 50-50. Take something 50% in something that's relatively safe and then put the other half into a diversified stock portfolio. I like to use exchange traded funds. I used to like to use individual stocks, but they move a lot faster than they used to. So I'm using funds that are picking stocks for us and will make changes. People are not cut out for today's financial markets as individuals. They're just not cut out for it. You can't convince me of that. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't be participating. You should be participating, and you should be using funds that are clearly defined so you can kind of get an idea of how they've done in the past. What did they do in 2000? What did they do in 2007, 8, 9? You get a pretty good idea of that, and then that's how you build the expectations in. So, okay, if this were to happen again, if the banks started losing a whole lot of money because a lot of the loans that they were making were bad, or if real estate started going bad like it did in the early 90s, and that contagion spread, how does that pan out for the strategy that I'm using? How has it done in the past? It's not going to repeat itself exactly, but at least it gives you an idea, something to build your opinion on. And if you can't take a 50% decline, don't put 100% of your money in stocks. It's that simple. Let's say you had 60% of your money in stocks, okay, and it gets cut in half. How much are you down by? You're down by 30%. 30% doesn't make you feel good, but it makes you feel a lot better than being down 50. And I'm sorry to say, but that's as good as it gets. That is literally as good as it gets. It's actually very simple. And again, anybody that's passed the CFA exam is really upset that I'm explaining this so simply and kind of making fun of it. That's too bad. I'm sorry you wasted all that time and money on that designation. But the reality is that's the way markets work. And it's fine. I mean, it's fine. Just have to be careful. Just sit down. It's common sense stuff when you got it, all the graphs in front of you. Unfortunately, you can't know exactly how you're going to do. That's where products that are going to guarantee minimum returns like treasury bills, or you get the fixed indexed annuities. Incidentally, because interest rates have gone up, the new rates on that, you probably want to check into. They're pretty good. They're very good. You can get guaranteed lifetime incomes without having to disinherit your beneficiaries. Back in when I first started in the industry, if you annuitized, that means you took the monthly income, you got a nice income. But once you passed away, the money went back to the insurance company. It didn't go to your beneficiaries if there was any left. Well, that's changed. You can actually take an income during your life. The money's going to be invested. If there's still money left there when you pass away, it goes to your beneficiaries. How cool is that? And if you want to add this thing called a rider, okay, a rider is like an insurance policy on an annuity, which in itself is a type of an insurance policy. It will guarantee that your family gets back at least the amount that you put into it. Let me tell you where that really comes in handy. Let's say you started off and you had, to keep my numbers easy and round, $100,000 invested in one of these. That was your investment. You were turn the income on, so you're taking money out. You're taking about 5% a year. Depends on your age. Actually, you should be getting a little bit more than that. The older you get, the higher percentage it is. I just pulled that right out of thin air, just for my example. So if you're taking out $5,000 a year and you did it for 3 years, that's $15,000. And then the market crashed and you got hit by a car and passed away. The worst case scenario is your family gets $85,000. The $100,000 minus the $5,000 a year that they gave you. So the rest of that money would go to your family. If you'd put that money in a stock fund and you're taking out $5,000 a year and you actually started taking it out in March of 2000, okay? March of 2003, you'd have about $38,000 to $40,000, depending on how many dividends you get. And that would be what your family would inherit, not the $85,000. They're gonna take that big loss. See, that's what I'm talking about with this. You're gonna get a guarantee of a much higher income than in most other types of fixed products. You get a guarantee on your family can't get back less than you've invested in it, no matter what happens in the market. That's pretty good from an estate planning standpoint. That's really good. From if you love your kids, that's a really good thing to do. Make sure that they're going to get the remainder of the money. And if the market had done better, let's say it had positive returns over that time period, they would get that number instead. Now, I'm going to tell you that the chances of that are not good, okay? Because taking out that high of a distribution from the investments, and if you've got a really bad time, or even a normal time period, if you had a good time period, there is a chance that you would get back, your family would get back more than you've invested minus what you've taken out. But, you don't know. So anyway, we're talking in case, worst case scenario, your family inherits what you've invested minus what you've taken out. If you haven't taken anything out, let's say you put $100,000 in, got hit by a car and you're gone and the market had crashed and was down 50%. Well, they will guarantee that your family would get back the full $100,000. Okay. So if you have more questions on that, I think these are great for fixed income investors, people who are nearing retirement, that maybe want to take out income to supplement their Social Security and pensions or whatever other income that they have. I think it's a really good idea. And they are very complicated. I will give you that. I have to spend an awful lot of time studying to keep up with all the changes that are going on in that industry. It's like Well, it's like everything else in life. The only constant is change now. And but right now, I think it's very attractive. You've also got treasuries out there, I think, are very attractive. If you don't have access to that, then you probably need to use some super short-term bond funds, because the long-term bond funds are getting crushed. I think that, like I said earlier in today's show, the 20-year treasury bond fund from iShares Barclays Index is down about 24% from where it peaked last December. That's a bond fund, a government bond fund. So you really have to know what you're doing. I feel bad for people because things are complicated. You know, they're very complicated. To explain what a premium or a discount to a bond is, how many days they accrue interest, why do bond prices move? There's a lot to have to know today. I just feel horrible for an average investor because you can't stick your money in a 10% guaranteed annuity like was available when I first started in the industry and just forget about it. That was easy. Those days are over. They've been gone a long time. The good news is that interest rates have moved up a little bit. So some of those interest rates are starting to climb back up again. And that's a good thing. That's a really good thing. And actually, there are certain sectors in the stock market, you know, for the other portion of your money, the money that you're going to need to grow faster than what you're taking out of that over the long run. There are a lot of good industries that you can invest in, or invest in funds that invest in those industries. And I think you're going to be fine there. If you got a 10-year time horizon, which you should have, if you're invested in stocks and you're not thinking 10 years into the future, you're making a mistake. I don't care what those Facebook ads say. If those guys could actually do what they say they're going to do, they wouldn't be selling that information. Anyway, you're listening to Bill Bullington right here on 1420. Stay tuned. I'll be right back.
Do you ever find yourself saying, I need a vacation? Vacation Fixation can help. At Vacation Fixation, we specialize in all-inclusive trips and cruises to Mexico, the Caribbean, and Disney vacations. Why choose us? Our clients book through Vacation Fixation because they are frustrated with online trip brokers and timeshare scams. Whether it's a weekend getaway, a family trip, spring break, or honeymoon, Vacation Fixation will personalize a trip just for you. Want to know the hottest destinations in Cancun, Punta Cana, Jamaica, or Puerto Vallarta? Interested in room upgrades, beach reviews, or details about resort restaurants? How about finding a trip with a direct flight? At Vacation Fixation, we take all of your specific travel requests and shop our suppliers to find the best deal. What's the cost? Our suppliers pay us so you don't have to. Call 330-573-8147 for more details. Or you can visit our website at vacationfixation.com or check out the deal of the day on Facebook. Vacation Fixation.
Is your job recession-proof? Now might be the perfect time to switch careers and become an IT professional with My Computer Career. IT is listed as one of the top recession-proof professions. You could have your dream job in just months, not years. No experience needed. Take classes online or on campus. And financial aid is available to those who qualify, including the GI Bill. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation. It's not rocket science. It's mycomputercareer.edu.
In the old Dracula movies, starring Bela Lugosi, all you had to do was show the cross, and the vampire would slink away. Well, we still have that cross. Only this time, that cross represents the truth. We have truth on our side. Truth, common sense, and the belief in what's right. Use the truth to win those arguments. And stay tuned to this station to find out what's real, what's true, and who's telling the lies. That's why we exist. AM 1420, The Answer.
And Odyssey. No doubt about it, we're spending more time at home, which is the perfect time to make it more functional and beautiful. Hi, Ed Flash Ferentz here for Artistic Renovations, Northeast Ohio's premier and award-winning remodeler. Artistic did a fantastic job with our kitchen in 2016, and last year, they were back for the master bath. Oh, my word. Do yourself a favor and go to ArtisticReno.com. Believe me, you'll love their ideas and without question, the finished product. For a virtual consultation, call 216-520-0838 or visit ArtisticReno.com.
Thinking about updating your home? Well, Joyce Factory Direct specializes in replacing old, outdated windows. Proudly made right here in Cleveland, Joyce Windows features their exclusive Smart Shield high-performance glass, which means you'll be getting the most energy-efficient windows for your home directly from the factory. Customers just love how much warmer their house is and how easy their new windows operate and clean. Right now, you can save 50% on all installations. Just call to schedule a free consultation with on-the-spot pricing, 440-243-5700, or visit JoyceFactoryDirect.com.
Looking for a great way to save on taxes? Look no more. Just call Our Lady of the Wayside at 1-800-368-6262 and ask about their car donation program. It's simple and it works for everyone involved. You donate your ride, you write off the selling price, and the money goes to help the physically and mentally challenged citizens served by Our Lady of the Wayside. The number to call, 1-800-368-6262.
Well, you want more, so get more. Need your ride to Our Lady.
Do you need The Answer on the go? Check out our all-new AM 1420 The Answer app on the Google Play Store or App Store.
I heard your heart, I see your pain, out in the dark, out in the rain. Feel so alone, feel so afraid. I heard you pray in Jesus' name. It may be midnight or midday. It's never early, never late. He gon' stand by what he claimed. I lived enough life to save. Help is on the way, round in the corner. Help is on the way.
Wow, how appropriate is that? You know, anytime I hear that, I love that song. Every time I hear that song, I crank it up really loud and I convince myself that I can sing. All the way up until I turn the volume down again. But anyway, it is a really nice song. Yeah, we were just talking a little bit about individual stocks, and I've gotten some requests. By the way, I'm looking at a scan right now, and it kind of gives you a pretty good idea of how strong or weak the whole stock market is by the number of companies that show up in the scan. And right now there are 90, and I can't remember seeing that many for several months. So now that can change tomorrow. I mean, there's no doubt about it. But it's a good sign when you're seeing 90 stocks meeting all the criteria of this one particular scan. And then I go and look at some of the valuations and some of the financial statements of a lot of these companies, and they're pretty good. So very encouraging to see good quality companies that are starting to move up. You know, that makes me happy, if you can't tell. But so anyway, and if you ever wanted to see that, we're going to, I can't remember if we have the space booked or not, but we're going to do another seminar, the kind we used to do, corporate college out on the east side, and it's a lot of fun. I will show these. Actually, I'll give you the criteria. I'll print it off and bring it with me if you wanted to subscribe to this software. It's like $50 a month, which is a deal, by the way, because when I give you my scan, I'm turning that into an institutional quality tool, which you would normally pay $2,000 to $3,000 a month just to have access to. And man, I'm glad I learned how to do that on my own. I don't have to pay all that extra money. But Telechart, TC2000 is the company. It's $50 a month. It's mind-boggling what you get. I can't believe all the money I spent earlier in my career to get access to this kind of stuff. It's one of the reasons I'm still working. Because I was an individual. I wasn't supported by an institution. I had to pay for it all myself. But I guess it's good. When you're spending a lot of money, you tend to pay attention to what's going on, or at least I do. Maybe some people don't, but anyway, could be very, very helpful. And I'm liking what I see, and I like the interest rates and the guaranteed rates on the fixed index annuities. They're really good right now. I mean, they're really good. Some of them, well, the vast majority of them are higher than most people have been averaging on their stock investments over the past 20 years. So that's very encouraging. You don't have to have nearly as much money at risk. You're going to have some money in stocks, though, because those fixed annuities are fixed. Okay, so if you're in your early 60s or mid 60s or even early 70s, you got another 15, 20 year life expectancy. You're going to want something that's keeping up with inflation, and that would be plus what you're taking out of it. Those would be stocks. You know, those would be stock investments. It's the only asset class that's ever been able to do that over long time periods. The key is you don't want to have so much invested in that when it goes down, it really hurts your ability to continue to take money out of it, because it, you know, every dollar you take out that's cut in half is not going to come back. I mean, you're spending them when they're down by half. It's almost impossible to make that back up. So you don't want more than, probably 40, 50% of your money invested that way when you are within 3 or 4 years of retirement. Now, I used to say 65% of your money invested that way, and you could still do that. You could, a 65-35, that would be fine. You got 35% of your money invested in fixed products, whether they're treasuries, short-term high-quality bonds, or fixed index annuities. Those are all different things, by the way. But they fit in that one category. They're safer than, well, quote-unquote safer, supposedly safer than investing in stocks, because stocks fluctuate so much more than they do. And stocks do fluctuate a lot. I mean, and there's no way of avoiding that. I mean, I still, to this day, it kills me that people call in and say, hey, where do you think the stock market will be, you know, 12 months from now or 6 months from now? You know what? If I knew the answer to that question, I wouldn't answer it anyway, because there's an investment you could make that would return about 150 times whatever you put into it. And I would put all my money in there and I'd be rubbing elbows with Elon Musk and Warren Buffett, because if you could really know that within 10 or 15% of the actual number, you know, that's amazing. So, and I know most people don't know what I'm talking about right now, but it's basically options on futures contracts. So if you really knew what was going to happen, you could get really, really, really rich really fast. The fact that there aren't thousands and thousands, actually millions of billionaires walking around on the planet, means that that's incredibly difficult to do. You know, somebody's going to win the lottery. It doesn't mean they're skilled. Think about that for a second. Anyway, I'll let you think about that for a long second. But where was I? I just lost my train of thought. Anyway, so I was talking about some individual stocks. And I know a lot of people like to talk about individual stocks. You know what's running right now? It kind of kills me, actually. Genworth Financial. You know, Genworth. This is GE Financial Arm, used to be. They got spun off. It's pretty amazing. The stock's only $4. The price to sales ratio on that thing is 0.25. I think the S&P's average is 3. They're 0.25. And now it's starting to move. It's about $4.18 as I speak. And that would be one of those stocks that could be a value play. It's an insurance company. So when rates go up, it will have a tendency to hurt insurance companies in the short run, because insurance companies have a ton of money in bonds. And when rates go up, bond prices go down. So it hurts them a little bit, but they'll just raise your premium next quarter, no sweat. I'm just kidding. Kind of. Anyway, there's Sanmina Corporation. I think that's a semiconductor company. I'm not really sure. I can't remember. But man, it was a lot higher in the year 2000 than it is today. Almost 10 times higher. That's mind-boggling. But it's breaking out above a level that was set back in 2016, 2017. It looks like a couple with a handle pattern on a weekly chart. So if you know what that means, great. If not, don't worry about it. It's not that important. skip it. You've only got a few thousand stocks to pick from, so it's not like we're going to run out of ideas or opportunities that come up. Here's one. It's wow, this is a company called Tile, and they actually do tile, like building product material, tiles. You know, that's their symbol is TILE, and not too bad. Price to sales ratio 0.66. That's not bad at all. It's on the move right now. And here's one. This is related to semiconductor industry. Photronics Incorporated, PLAB. Its chart looks better than the other charts. It's a large range day. If you don't know what that is, come to the next seminar. I'll show you. But large range days on volume that's above average, generally pretty good. The fact that it's in an industry that's been running like crazy, where the demand is up a lot, sales growth is up a lot, that's good. Its symbol is PLAB. The price is $23.21. If these are only for aggressive investors, by the way, these are for long. They're actually long-term traders. You don't want to day trade this. Actually, you don't want to day trade anything. You want to try to locate those things that you think have the best probabilities or possibilities of going up more than 20% or so over the next few weeks. And I'm looking to normally double my money, and that's what I would like to do. It's got a price to sales ratio of 1.22, which is a lot higher than Genworth at 0.25, but the industry average for that thing is about 6. So if you could buy something at $1.22 that you would normally pay $6 for, that's a deal. So in its industry, it's a pretty good deal. And I really like the chart pattern. So I'll leave that one alone. And by the way, if you have any questions on any of this stuff, this part, I don't really do a lot of individual trading anymore. I'll probably buy that one tomorrow. I'll just put a market order in and put a trailing stop on it and let it rip. But I don't do a ton of that anymore. It's only with about, you know, I'm going to say 20% of my total portfolio is attributed or at least allocated to individual stocks. And I normally hold about 20 stocks. So realistically, I'm only putting 1% of my money in each stock. And I know a lot of people are going, well, 1%, that's not going to make a big difference. Yeah, but I'm not going to get killed either. And I don't have the time to sit there and babysit and watch them. I buy them on the open and I put a trailing stop loss order on it and I just let it rip. You know, so, and I don't have 20 stocks right now. I had to use exchange traded funds because this is actually the first time in months, maybe in over a year, that I've seen companies that have decent valuations that are running up pretty quickly. And this is relatively new. So that's what keeps me interested in this. It's always changing. It'll go from really heated to really, it'll cool off very quickly and then heat back up again. And if you're paying attention, you know, it can help. If not, you need to be using exchange traded funds. There are some funds that do extremely similar stuff to this. I really like what's happened in that industry. They have come out with some excellent products, excellent ideas. I try to hold as many of them as I can. I just really like it. When you understand what makes a stock go up, in the short run, by the way, that's anything less than a couple of years, it's the buying and selling. And in order to get that right, you've got to either anticipate or just observe. Anticipating is projecting, is predicting. That is the hardest way you can pick stocks that I know of when you're looking for short-term gains. Observation, like Photronics Labs, when I see this stock is the volume's up more than its average daily volume, that the stock's closing, it's right at its high of the day right now. By the way, I'm talking about this during the week because I pre-recorded this show. And its range is more than its average daily range. It's up 7.3% for the day, but it's just now passing the high point that it reached back in June. In June, it got to this point, went down, looks like about 25% or so. Now it's ripping back up again, and it just took out that 52-week high. So that's pretty substantial. Now, for all those of you that are listening to this and don't know what I'm talking about, I'm going to stop now. For you guys that have been bugging me about talking about stocks again, there you go. I try to please you if you can. And just know that there are a lot of companies that are running right now. They're, the industry growth in the entire world is being held back by supply chain problems. Supply chains are very difficult, especially with the war going on in Europe. That has really tied a knot in a lot of things. It was hard before they started the invasion, and now it's just slowed a lot of things down to a snail's pace. But I'm amazed that the economy hasn't contracted more than it has. It just blows my mind how resilient it's been. So I can only imagine what might happen as this stuff starts to clear away and recover. And I look at the underlying growth of a lot of the industry. Healthcare and semiconductors are still my favorite. And healthcare's been beat. I mean, it's been down a lot. If you're really like one of the buy low, sell high people, you might want to be looking into those those healthcare stocks or the funds that invest in them. I have a model that I use, and I haven't been super happy with it over the past year because it's been beat like a lot of other things. But the valuations in that industry are great. And with the demographics of the world, you know, we're getting older. And you know what happens when you get older? You go to the doctor, like a lot more. Like I can tell you, firsthand experience. I've watched it my entire career because the average people that are under the age of 50 are typically not the ones with the most money. Now, some of them do, but the vast majority of them are older than 50. And right now, the fastest growing segment of the population is 16 over. I can see it, and I'm feeling it myself, by the way. So I go to the doctor way more than I used to go. I would never go to the doctor when I was a young man. I would just suck it up. But at some point in time, you just got to give in and start going to the doctor. And so I look at all the healthcare stocks, and the valuations are really good. The growth rates are good. The demographics are good. Hey, you know, how do I take advantage of that? Well, I've got a model for that. Same thing with the semiconductors. Same thing with mid-cap stocks. There are a couple of funds that I really like in that area. Same thing with some dividend-paying stocks, if you're one that likes dividends. It's amazing. There's so many choices out there. That makes it hard on an individual investor, by the way, because the more choice you have, the longer you have a tendency to think about it. So you really want to try to find out what is it that you really want to achieve. Stocks that have high quality sales, high quality profits, and pay dividends generally have a good combination of long-term growth, or have in the past, and actually the funds that pick those types of stocks will eliminate those stocks who slow down or cut their dividend, or the dividend becomes or unlikely that it's going to stay as high as it is. So they're being managed, and that can really help you out in your retirement years. Now that I hear the music, you're going to have to wait till next week to find out how, or you can call me. This is Bill Billington. I'm here every week from Saturday morning, 11 to noon. Have a good weekend, everybody. Good luck. Good investing.
You just caught another edition of the Bullington Capital Report, broadcasting every Saturday at 11 a.m. on AM 1420, The Answer. If you have a question and you'd like to speak to Bill personally, you can call him at 330-664-0700. That's 330-664-0700. That's bullingtoncapital.com.
Past performance may not be indicative of future results. Therefore, no current or prospective client should assume that the future performance of any specific investment strategy, including the investments and or investment strategies recommended and or purchased by advisor or product made reference to directly or indirectly will be profitable. Different types of investment involve varying degrees of risk, and there can be no assurance that any specific investment will either be suitable or profitable for a client's investment portfolio. No client or prospective client should assume that any information presented serves as the receipt of or substitute for personalized investment advice from the advisor or any other investment professional. The preceding program has been paid for by Bullington Capital Management, LLC.